If this is your introduction to XNAT, let's talk about what you can do with it. XNAT was built to support imaging research workflows, and at its heart, that means managing a ton of data. And so XNAT was built around the ability to organize that data and decide who has access to what. And then there are all kinds of tools in XNAT that give you a lot of functionality to work with that data. And I'm just going to walk through, at a high level, what the core functionality is. So first, you can organize your data by creating projects and then defining what describes that project and who can see it and who explicitly has access to it and in what roles. You can invite new users as well here. And you can even connect to external authentication systems such as LDAP and OpenID. And you can do a lot of customization from one project to the next to specify how you want to manage your data. Of course, you can add data to your project. You can add subjects. You can add clinical data in various forms. You can add image data in whatever form it comes in. And you can add pretty much any other file type as a resource all up and down your project. In short, XNAT's hungry for your data. There are specific workflows for adding imaging data in particular. Notably, you can anonymize the DICOM of incoming image data. And you can upload either data that you've got stored locally, or you can get data from a PACS system, whether it's acting as a receiver on the PACS network or through a DQR plugin, querying a PACS and retrieving data. Once you've got your image data in your XNAT, you can do all kinds of things with it. You can view the data, you can QC it and set quality, and you can annotate that data and save those annotations with a powerful new XNAT OHIF viewer. You can also explore your data, imaging and clinical. You can perform searches and save those searches as reports, which you can then share with other users. And you can even access data from outside your XNAT through authenticated APIs. You can also run processing on your data. You can run containerized algorithms and store the outputs, or you can run legacy XML-based pipelines. And again, any scripted interactions you have with external tools, you can also port the outputs of those interactions back into your XNAT as well. And then when you've got your data ready to share, you can invite collaboration within your XNAT. You could share the data to other projects, or you could even push the data out as a public release to a public XNAT. And of course, you can download data in all its forms. You can download the image data, the resource files, XML metadata, pretty much anything you need to take your research beyond and go to the next step. And that's really just core usability. There's a lot more that you can do. XNAT is wildly customizable, particularly with admin permissions. So you can learn more through our documentation at xnat.org or through XNAT Academy.